Right, we're going to look at negative and fractional indices today by looking at this problem that encapsulates both of these topics, and yeah, we'll get right into that now. So this is actually quite a simple problem when we know what it means to have fractional indices and negative indices. So let's run through that now. If we have a to the power of minus 1, then this is the same as 1 over a, and if we have a to the power of 1 over x, this is the same as taking the x root of a. So using that here, minus 3 over 2, well, this is the same as writing this problem as 25 to the power of minus 1 times by 3 over 2. Okay, so we take that power of minus 1 first. So that's the same as having this as 16 over 25 to the power of 3 over 2. This 2 here is the same as taking the square root. So if we take the square root of the top and bottom, this is now like having 4 over 5 raised to the power of 3. And now we just raise the top and bottom to the power of 3. And this is equal to 64 over 125.